Hey guys! Today we are going to make a dream catcher, as you see, because I'm the Damien. Damien makes the dream catchers. I'm pretty sure you all know that though, by last video. But we're going to make something similar to this, which I made the other day. Oh yeah, excuse that. That was from something else. I was a painting. But, so, this one, as you see, has the little designs on it where it has the crescent. Now you will learn how to do that in 1 second. JK, probably just a couple seconds. So you will start with a ring. This one will be a little smaller than that one. And after, alright, you'll need a ring. You'll need leather wrap, any color. Wax thread or any type of thread that you want. And my tools I'm using is scissors and I use wire cutters to cut the leather wrap. Alright, so first we're going to be starting off with the outline with the leather wrap. As you know from last time, don't twist it. So you have this. Scroll it until you think you have enough. Well, unwrap it from my little tube. For this one, I'm just unwrapping it all since I'm pretty sure I don't have enough. But hey, there's probably just gonna be access. So on mine, I have this little thing on it. Just cut that off. See? You don't want that. Alright, so we have this long piece of leather wrap. You'll start by this end here. Start by this end here. And you will take it and I'm just going to zoom in a lot here. Take it from underneath. And then make a square knot. So if you don't know how to make a square knot, like in the last video, we will cross like this, and you have the bunny hole. Take the bunny, which is this, and make it go through the bunny hole. And then, after that, pull. But you're gonna have to do that twice, like this. And make a square knot. Through the hole and pull. So after that, you take your uncertain amount of leather wrap, take the other end, put it on, I can't find the camera, hold them upside down, like that, open up your fingers a little, and just wrap it all around. Actually, you know what? We're just gonna move the cam. But I think that's fine, guys. Yeah. So, after this, yes, this is my little workspace downstairs. You're going to go here. Start by twisting it. Don't worry, you guys don't need to see this. And then start wrapping it. Like this. And make sure you have no twists. So I'll see you guys when we're done wrapping, which will be right now. So after you're good with the hold on. And there. After you're good with this be a little slippy slidey though, but damn it. You will take your little pliers here and cut it the excess off. Then over here, no one wants that. Cut that off too. And do this more. Wait, this, do that to tighten it up and stuff. So it looks better. Alright, that's done. We got to go to East. The leather wrap. Let me get a big piece out so we can make this dream catcher a dream catcher to do the inside net. So you keep bumbling it. So you think you have the right amount. Don't need a lot, but just enough. Take your scissors, trusty little scissors, to do that. So, rapidy, 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 rap. Oh yeah, while you're watching the video, how about hit the subscribe button, like and subscribe, and make sure to hit that bell button to get notified on every video that we make. Just want to get that out there while we make this video. Building me rolling. Don't judge the singing. So, when you finish with this video, how about, or just do it now, comment below if you think you like this channel. Because my parents put a lot of work into it, and so do I, to make this a good thing. My milestone that I want to reach by the end of August is I want to reach 50 subscribers. That's my milestone. I want you to keep that in mind. My family is wanting this so much. But, alright. Go over here. Please excuse my dark hair. I'm having trouble getting this on camera. So, you take it, and when you have your... you know what? Go back. That's what I said. So once you have that, you want to go under like this, that over into that. And then twist it. Hold on. How do you do that? And you have the perfect size. Now this one, the next one, do the same thing. And you do that over and over again. And you do it here. Dead silence, I know, right? Sucks. Alright, after that. Good. Here, make sure all of them are like the same size and same width apart, same length apart, I meant. Trusty little roll. Put through. So you don't have to do the roll. But, oh well, I do. There you have that. Now, the last one. Well, not really the last. We gotta finish the rest of the drink. But, oh well! If you think this is boring, the end of making a dream catcher, the last step is the best step, the decorating the bottom. But when you're here and you finished it all around like that, all the way around and stuff, you want to take your dream catcher and go flip and do the rest. Except here. Well, let's flip back. We're back to here. You want to take it and knot it. Hey! The heck is trying to unravel. But oh well. You're here, you don't want to knot the thing. I'm not saying N-O-T, I'm saying K-N-O-T. Just to let you know. So, once you knotted that down and all that, it should be set for the next step. And the next step is tricky. So, once you're there, you flip it over. Wax it, do the big hole through the middle. To where your wax is facing the bottom. What the hell, doesn't matter. And you go. And you just start again. Do it over and over. I say my favorite dream catcher though is making the regular dream catcher but having it have 10 sides. That's my favorite type. Or the star. So basically you do a regular dream catcher but do it 5 sides instead of like a kajillion. You make a star. A star circle. See? It'll make a star like this. But, focus on the dream catcher. Ha ha ha. Thank you. We're here again. So after you're here, you want to do the same nodding thing. Where you knock it together. K-N-O-T. Reminder. See, I just unraveled most of my thing now, so it makes it easier. Sorry about the robot talk. But, oh well. So what, I'm a kid. Kid's robot talk. Hold on, let me knock this real quick. Knock. So, you get the process, I hope. You go, then you not, then you flip it over and do it again. So, after that, now you will see the finished product. That's what it looks like. When it's done, mostly though. So, snip off that excess. No one wants that. Alright. So, I suggest doing it once, and twice, and three times, and four times. That makes it the best. See? Like this one. I love it rapidly, though. Don't worry about that. So, don't throw this away! Underneath it. Take it, take your snippers, cut it in half, there. It's definitely not half, but I don't care. You fold it like this, like the other time, and you take it. Like this, here. And fold it like that. Like that. Gonna put one there, I'm gonna put one there. Yeah, definitely not in half at all, but oh well.
So after that, your next two things will be
is this, a whole lot of beads, and feathers. Now, feathers I can't do because I have none. But you can put on feathers and I'll show you how. Because I have one purple example feather. So when the bead is all the way, so when the bead's all the way through this, what you'll do on it is you'll take the thing of the feather and go clomp. And squish it through the bead like that. Except they're not doing that now. We are just gonna put on the beads. Pick what colors. I like doing a whole mixture of them, but just don't use them a whole lot though. I usually use like three of them for each one. Two. Three and four. There. Take all of these beads, toss them back. This one. Toss them there. Runaway bead and toss them in there and that one. So now,
slide. Take this bead. Slide it through the hole. Like that. Then you want to do that. Three of them is what I do. See? You just do a simple thing. Make a loop. Take the bunny around, do that, hold the knot, pull the bunny. That makes your thing of beads. Do that. Couple more times. Wait. This. And another one on the other side, and then come out for you. Three. And three. He's a lonely bead. And what I'll do is I'll take the two of these, cross them over, and just tie them up here. I'll just do that sometimes. Do another square knot, like the beginning, for here. But after you do that, we are so close. Snip this. That one. Notch. There. So when you're done with your dream catcher, you will have something like this with feathers. But I must say that you kind of have a mess to clean up after it. So I'm upside down. Never mind. But thank you guys for watching. And if you like this video, then subscribe. This dream catcher will be on sale at Pagan Prides at Michigan. So if you want to go there, I'm going to be selling them and also doing lessons for children and any adults who want to learn how to make a dream catcher. So please like and subscribe, like to Facebook, as my dad says, but